a very, very special night. You know, this is the second night of this show, and we had a blast last night, and I know tonight's going to be even better. So I want to welcome you. You know, there's a Japanese word that means, it's one that has meant a lot to my life, and it's okage-sama de. It means I am what I am because of you. And tonight, you know, being up here on stage, sharing the stage a little bit later with the great McAnally. You know, he's a big reason, you know, why I am the musician that I am today. He introduced me to Jimmy Buffett back in 2006. And I became an official Core Reefer band member, you know? And, but he's just been such a great mentor and friend. And tonight we are all here to celebrate the music and the stories, but more importantly, the life of the great Jimmy Buffett. So I know we're here at the Blue Note, but we're gonna turn it into a little Margaritaville tonight, I think. So let's have a great time tonight. Thank you so much for being here. And this is a song that kind of started it all for me. You know, when I met Mac, he pulled me on the side one day. I think he saw a video of me playing this George Harrison piece, and he said, I need to come up with 11 more arrangements like that, and I need to record an album. And he produced my first real solo ukulele record called Gentle Weeps, and that's what started all of this. So this is a song that started it all. Thank you.
Good thing I love that guy, because otherwise it would be no fun trying to follow him. It is such an honor to get to play here with my little brother and honor my big brother. That's what we're doing tonight. You may not see the natural family resemblance between Jake and myself. But it's there. It's on the inside. What a sweet soul. I've been saying it for over 10 years. He could be half as good as he is, and he'd be still the best in the world. And don't be frightened. You're only going to have to put up with a small amount of me by myself, and then we're all going to get back up here and make some biblical joyful noise.
Love you, Matt.
Thank you so much. So proud to be here. And the sort of theme of the evening is we're going to honor Jimmy Buffett because he's the nexus between the two of us. And he's honestly, Jimmy took me under his wing. He believed in me before I ever believed in myself. And I certainly would not be here or probably anywhere in the music business. I would be an extremely less than mediocre farmer in North Mississippi if it weren't for Jimmy. So the idea is to honor some of his music and to give you a couple of maybe inside stories for some of it. I'm going to start with one, not necessarily a very familiar song, but it's a song I had the privilege of writing with Jimmy. And he called me. He was working on his first book, Tales from Margaritaville. And he had this lovely place over in Thomasville, Georgia. He was holed up working on the book, and he asked if I would come over and help him write a song. You should do that if Jimmy Buffett asked you to come and write a song. And I did. And I got over there, and he said, I want to write a song about one of the characters in my book. And I said, well, I don't know anything about your book. He said, doesn't matter. Play something in D. We goofed around for an hour or so, didn't really have anything going. He had a barbecue place he was really proud of, and he took me to lunch there. And they didn't have any tables. We were just a gravel road parking lot. we're sitting in his Jeep eating a barbecue sandwich, and I've got sauce running down my arm. And he had an early version before cell phones. He had a car phone mounted in the console of his Jeep, big cumbersome thing. I didn't have one yet, so I'm kind of tech envious of Jimmy. And he's showing off the buttons and what it'll do. And halfway through the meal, he reaches behind him and he pulls out his laptop computer and plugs it up to this car phone thing. I said, "What are you doing?" He said, "I'm faxing the last chapter of my book to the publisher." I said, "In the parking lot of a barbecue place in Georgia?" I said, "Yeah, cool, huh?" "I'm just trying to hold on to my sandwich." He's way ahead of me in the tech world, and he always was. But we went back to his house, and I got in D again like I was supposed to. And he told me he wanted to write a song about this lady character in one of his short stories. And this is how you write a song with Jimmy. He said, I was playing a D chord, and he said, "Girl of a Thousand Faces." And I said, "From a long line of basket cases." That's how I roll. And this is what came of that. I appreciate your tolerance, folks. Girl of a thousand faces, from a long line of basket cases, daughter of a fortune teller, oh, the lovely Isabella, she's changing channels, staying on her toes, she's just changing channels as she goes. Places full of beachhead sailors, fishermen and old retailers, simple lives are so deep-seated, history will be repeated. Some folks have a bird's eye view, others haven't got a clue. Some will go and some will stay, doesn't matter. Crazy girls and boys, they keep changing channels, changing toys. Survivors of tidal waves, children of former slaves. Strange how they all behave, like it's another world. There's an island where the people stay in motion, somewhere on the old Gulf Stream. Did they live? Did I dream? We were changing channels. Crazy girls and boys, we just changed a channel, changing toys. Changing channels, waiting for our sails to fill. We keep changing channels, always will. Always will.
Standing next to Jimmy Buffett, you know. So hearing all those songs and then playing them again, and just so many memories were just kind of running through my head, and it was just surreal. But you know, there's so many great moments with Jimmy. One of the things I love sharing the story of how I first met him. You know, of course, Mac introduced, told Jimmy about me, and so when they came out to Hawaii back in 2006 to do their concert at the Waikiki Shell, I was on my way to a radio interview, and I remember when I walked in, it was a little surf shop here in Waikiki, and I walked in and the DJ came running. I said, "Oh my goodness, Jake, you're not going to believe it, but Jimmy Buffett was in here and he saw that you were going to be coming in, but he left a note for you." I thought they were just playing a joke on me, right? So I was like, yeah, whatever. But anyways, I'll never forget, because it was he hands me this flyer. It was the Wailers were coming into town and they were doing a show. So on the back of the Wailers flyer, it had this note from Jimmy, and it said, "Hey Jake, you know, this is Jimmy Buffett. I'm in town, I'm doing a show. I want to invite you out to our show, you know, tomorrow night." And so I was like, "What? Is this real?" And he left the number and everything. So I was like, "Oh, this can't be real." So after the interview, I, "You know, please, you know, I want to tell Jimmy I'm a huge fan and thank him for me." And he said, "Oh, well, that's too bad, you know, because Jimmy really wanted you to sit in with the band." And I said, "Mike, let me call you right back." Long story short, I got to play with Jimmy Buffett and Coral Reapers the next time.
And you still got the whole family.
Family still loves you.
Well,
I'm a one-man band with his feet in the sand. Tonight I just need my guitar. Don't need to be important or famous. No limo or no little dash car. One lucky man, no immediate plans. Tonight I just need thank you. my job, but without it I'd be less than what I expect to be. I've been lazy most all my life, writing songs and sleeping late. Any manual labor I've done was purely by mistake. The street sweepers can smile, and I've got no right to feel upset. But sometimes I still forget till the lights go on and the stage is set. And the song hits home, and you feel that sweat is my job to be different than the rest. And that's another reason to go for me. It's my job to be better than the best. And that's a tough break for Matt. It's my job to be cleaning up this mess. And that's another reason to go for me. It's my job to be better than the best, and that makes the day for me. Maybe someday I'll hear from a friend or from a stranger, it's a whole lot better on account of you.